Hello friends, my name is Mohsin Mulla and I welcome you all to this third video lecture of Unit 4 of Electrical Installation and Estimation. In this video lecture, we are going to see measurement of insulation resistance of the cables. So insulation resistance is nothing but the resistance of that PVC or any other material insulation covering provided on the top of a conductor in the cable. So in this picture you can see a single core cable. So here there is a conductor part, on top of that conductor part there is an insulation layer provided. This insulation layer, it prevents the live conductor from coming in contact with the grounded part of the cable, like external sheet available on top of this insulation, or if there is any other conductor lying, so that insulation will prevent this conductor in coming contact with the other live conductor here. So now this is the, we can say, layer of the insulation. The thickness of this insulation depends upon the voltage capacity of this particular cable. Okay, so now what is insulation resistance? Now here this particular thickness of the insulation will definitely offer a barrier for the flow of current from this conductor towards the surface of the insulation or any metallic part which is available. So usually the current will try to move in this direction here. Okay, so therefore insulation is nothing but, insulation resistance is the opposition offered by the insulation for the leakage current. So therefore in this picture you can see that here the leakage current is trying to move in the radial direction across the entire surface area of the entire thickness of the insulation over here. Okay, so now, so usually what will be present on the top of this insulation layer is a metallic sheet. Okay, so this metallic sheet is connected to the ground. This metallic sheet is usually placed to prevent it, prevent the moisture to get inside this conductor cable here. So this metallic lead sheet will be connected to the ground, so it will be, which will be at the zero potential here, and this conductor when carrying the current will be at the high voltage. Therefore the current will start flowing from the higher potential to lower potential surface. So that is nothing but the leakage current which is indicated here. Now if the insulation is in good condition, in that case this leakage current will be very minimum, which do not affect the operation of the cable. But sometimes, so it may happen that the insulation resistance will get deteriorated over a period of time. In that case the leakage current may rise and the total operation of the cable will be hampered in that case. Okay, so now let us see how we can obtain the insulation resistance of this cable here. So say this particular cable is having two circular faces. So one is the conductor, so having a say radius of R1, and the second one is the surface of the insulation from the center of the cable at a radius of R2. And let us say the resistivity of this insulating material is rho, and let us consider a part of the cable length to calculate the resistance of this insulation over here. Now usually the perception will be that, as we know, the formula for resistance is rho L by A. So what usually people think, that as the length of the cable increases, the insulation resistance will also increase, as it seems like it is directly proportional in this particular case. But that is not true in case of the insulation resistance, because this formula is for the current carrying path. So here this length actually indicates the length of the current carrying path. So in that case this length is not the length of the cable, but rather this is the length of the cable insulation which will be allowing the current, leakage current, to flow through it. Now this particular length of the conductor is a different length, and when the resistance is obtained for this conductor, at that time this length will be the L. But now in case of a insulation resistance, the length that we are talking about is this length over here. So we can see that from this next cut section over here. So now let us say if you want to determine the total resistance of the insulation here, so let us take a small portion of the thickness of the insulation, so that we are going to estimate over a total length here. Okay, so now this distance from say R1 to R2, so this distance will be acting as the total length of the cable, total length of the path for the current leakage current flow. Okay, so that to obtain that, let us consider a small portion of this length, that is dr, and when we integrate over the total distance between R1 and R2, we will get the total length in the formula for that calculation of resistance. Now let us first calculate the area of this particular insulation here. Okay, so now to obtain the area, let us consider this small portion of whatever thickness dr we have considered for a length of L here. So let us say this is the portion we have cut from the available insulation, and let us take it for the length L. Okay, so now to obtain the total surface area available in this length, so what I will do, I will just take a cutter and cut this particular section in this way, and I will open it this side and this side. So now what you are going to see is a rectangular shape which will look like this, and here you can see that the length remains same horizontally as it is, but this total surface is, say this is what we have obtained earlier, that cylinder is having a radius of R from the center, so therefore the surface or periphery of this particular cylindrical shape is nothing but length 2 pi r. When you open the circle at that time, we'll get the length of periphery as 2 pi r. Therefore the area of this particular surface is 2 pi r l. Okay, so you need to remember this, it is 2 pi r l. So here a is 2 pi r l, and we have to integrate this particular dr, small length dr, over the total length from R1 to R2 in order to obtain the total resistance over the available path here. So here you can see this is the length available will be R2 to R1. So now to obtain how much you can say resistance will be offered by this, we have to integrate this small resistance value over the distance from R1 to R2. So like by using this integration here, so now this is the formula that we had. So this is our new L, because we have taken a very small amount of L, and this is the new denominator A. Now we are going to integrate this small length dr from R1 to R2. So it will give us whatever length is available. When the thickness of the insulation will change, at that time the length between R1 and R2 will change, but still the ends will be from R1 to R2. Hence it will give us the direct relationship between the, you can say, the resistance as well as the length of the cable and the total thickness of the insulation here. So now rho and this denominator 2 pi L are constant, so they can be taken outside, not R. 2 pi L are taken constant and they are taken outside, and we get here just integration between R1 to R2. Okay, so integration between R1 to R2 1 by R dr. So integration of that is log R. Now substituting here the limits R1 and R2, so we get log to the base E R2 by R1. So now this is the formula to calculate the total length of the whatever cable insulation we have here, or we can substitute this log ER as it is in terms of the difference of the this is rho divided by 2 pi L, then log of R2 minus R1. So this is what we are going to get. Now from this particular formula, what you can observe is R is inversely proportional to L. So this is very important point you need to remember. This will be asked in many objective type of questions and also competitive examinations, that insulation resistance is inversely proportional to the length of the cable. okay, it is not directly proportional for the, as it is in the case of the conductor. Okay, so it is inversely proportional. So as length increases, the insulation resistance is going to decrease. Okay, so you need to remember that. So now let us see why we need to measure the insulation resistance. So insulation, why insulation resistance test is done? Insulation starts to age as soon as it's made. As it ages, its insulating performance deteriorates. Any harsh installation environments, especially those with temperature extremes or changes in the voltages or changes in the surrounding chemicals, may accelerate this type of deteriorating process. Therefore, the resistance of the insulation will start deteriorating as time passes. So we have to ensure that the insulation of the cable is having the proper resistance so as to maintain the proper operation of the normal operation of the cable. So therefore, different methods are employed to measure the insulation resistance. So here we have one method, that is measurement of insulation resistance using galvanometer. So here galvanometer is usually used to measure the small amount of current that will be flowing. So therefore, when there is a very high resistance, in that case we need to use a galvanometer to measure the resistance. So here basically what is done, so high voltage in terms of say 1 kilovolt is applied from this DC supply or AC supply from this terminal here. Now this is directly connected to the this end is directly connected to the conductor part of the cable, and other end is connected to the metallic sheet, okay, which is in which is attached to the surface of the insulation. Therefore the path for the current flow is from the conductor to this metallic sheet, from conductor to this metallic sheet. So if the insulation is having good resistance, in that case this leakage current will be very small. If this if the insulation is not in good condition, at that time the leakage current will be larger and larger. Hence directly we can get the insulation resistance of the cable by using a simple formula of Ohm's law: applied voltage divided by the current, leakage current that is flowing in the conductor, from conductor to the surface of the sheet. So that is IR. In this case it is indicated as IR. Now this IL part is, it is just the leakage current, okay, so that will be wound on the surface of the insulation. So that is the leakage current that will be flowing from the supply to the surface of the insulation. It is not through the insulation, it is just on the surface of the insulation, okay, that is between the surface of the insulation and the sheet. It is only for that. Here we are trying to measure the resistance between the surface of the conductor and the surface of the sheet, that is the total surface of the conductor, then surface of the insulation, then there is this surface of the sheet. So we want to measure what is the resistance from here to here. So that resistance is measured as this. Okay, so where IR is the direct leakage current that is flowing here. Okay, now so whatever I explained, the same theory part is available here. Next method is using a Megger, insulation resistance measurement using Megger. So in this case, so a Megger is nothing but a handheld generator which will generate high voltage when a generator is rotated. So now here it is having three terminals. Out of that, so line terminal and earth terminal are made use to measure the resistance of a conductor insulation, resistance of the insulation. So now here we are considering a single core cable. So the line terminal of the Megger is connected to the conducting part of the cable, and the earth is again connected to the this metallic sheet part, okay, which is on the surface of the insulation. Okay, so now it will directly measure the resistance between this conducting part and the metallic sheet part. Okay, so again here what exactly will happen is explained with the help of this working principle of the Megger. So line is having a coil and there is a resistance, and then this earth is also having coils and resistance. Now here also you can see in this picture as it is shown. So this line conductor is connected from here to here, Okay, so when the current is flowing, in that case the coil, which is this coil, will deflect the pointer, will deflect this pointer on the Megger scale, which will directly indicate the resistance value. Usually here the Megger pointer will be at the infinity value and other side is the zero value. Okay, and when the resistance is very high, the current is zero, in that case this deflection torque will be zero. In that case the pointer will not deflect from this position to this position, but as soon as the current will start flowing, then the current is flowing in the coil and there is a deflection torque which will make the pointer to move towards this direction. So here it is going to indicate some resistances in terms of mega ohms. Okay, so insulation resistances will be usually in terms of mega ohms, 2 to 50 mega ohm and so. So always the insulation resistance will be in terms of 5, 10 mega ohms, etc. Okay, similarly there is second coil which will be acting as the control coil. So this is the control coil parts here. So this will be controlling the deflection. So usually when the current is not flowing through the line, in that case the current is entirely flowing through the this controlling coil and the pointer will be held exactly at the infinity. But as soon as current is flowing in the deflection coil, it is moving the pointer against the that controlling torque, and hence when the controlling and deflection torque will become equal, in that case it is going to stand and it will indicate the insulation value of the resistance. So here is another picture of the same Megger. And here you can see for the 3 core cable. So in case of measurement of insulation resistance of a 3 core cable, so one core is connected to the line terminal, okay, and other two cores are short circuited first, and the earth terminal is connected to this short circuited core and the external metallic sheet which is at the ground potential. Now the current will be leaking through the conductor through this insulation, and it will go to this metallic sheet, as well as it can go to the other conductor. So whether it is going to the conductor or to the metallic sheet, the same is actually providing the value of the insulation resistance. So again here the Megger is going to indicate directly the insulation resistance value. This side it is infinity and this side it is zero. So usually it will be indicating some value because resistance cannot be infinite. So always there will be some higher value of the resistances, like 50 mega ohm will be the usually the cable insulation resistance. So in this way we can measure the resistance of the insulation. And once we ensure that the insulation resistance is as per the values, required values, then we can let the cable to be continued in operation. But once the insulation resistance decreases beyond say 2 mega ohm value, usually the good resistance or very good insulation resistance is between 10 to 50 mega ohm. But even if it is between 5 to say 10 mega ohm, at that time it is abnormal resistance. Okay, it is not the good, but once it comes below 5 mega ohm, in that case the insulation is in the critical condition and we need to replace the conductor or cable completely in order to have the good insulation cable in the operation there.